On Hot Copy this morning, the Office of the Vice President has begun a free telecon service to help decongest hospitals. The initiative aims to provide medical assistance to outpatient cases, especially those with limited access to doctors. It's a privilege to have her once again this morning. We have with us Vice President Leni Robredo. Madam Vice President, good morning to you.
Good morning, Karen. Good morning, everyone.
All right, let's start first. Just yesterday, you already launched itong e-telecon and itong e-konsulta. You actually had an impressive number of volunteers signed up. At least what I read last is 2,300. Is still the latest number?
We stopped after 24 hours, Karen. We announced the call. We did the call Monday evening. And we stopped getting volunteers Tuesday evening because we had quite a lot already. What we want now, Karen, is it's just a temporary stoppage, but we want to have everyone on board already. So what we did the entire day yesterday, Wednesday and yesterday, we were meeting with batches of volunteers so that we can prepare them with the protocols that we will be following.
Okay.
So, About of the 2,300, Karen, about 500 are doctors. The rest are non-medical people who want to help with the back-end operations.
Okay. Madam Vice President, para maintindihan ng tao, marami ang teleconsulting right now. Maraming telemedicine. But what makes e-consulta different? What makes this unique?
Actually, Karen, we already posted on our Facebook pages all the links, all the numbers of all the existing teleconsultation platforms available. But the problem is we were still getting a lot of calls. We were still getting a lot of messages asking help. And I think one of the reasons is that not all of the teleconsultation platforms existing are accessible to people.
Okay.
Karamihan sa kanila would need internet connection.
Uh-oh.
Kaya yung ginawa natin, it's available on free data.
Okay.
Kaya Facebook siya. It's been difficult, Karen. It's been difficult in the sense now we had to go through
Facebook ito, Vice President. Facebook. Okay.
Uh-oh. They message. We created a new Facebook page. And the name of the Facebook page is Bayanihan E-konsulta. So may nag-post kami sa aming existing Facebook pages how to access. And then you do that on Messenger because Facebook and Messenger are both available on free data.
Correct.
So kahit yung mga walang data available, they can avail of the service.
Uh-oh. What about landline? I'm curious if you've thought of that. Is that a possibility?
Pwede ang landline, Karen, when the doctors speak to the patients already.
Okay.
Pero when they register, it's really Facebook. Unless we receive messages from other sources. And then what we do is, even if they don't go through the Bayanihan e-konsulta messenger app, we still get the details of people who contact us. Halimbawa, ako mismo, Karen. Ang dami sa akin nagko-contact. So what I do is I include them in the platform and then our agents call the patients and link them with the available doctors.
Okay. Okay. Now, let's say the person is COVID positive. Ayaw pumunta sa ospital. What happens now? Are the doctors licensed or I would say, will you have nurses taking the call or hindi naman? Only doctors?
We actually have volunteer medical professionals who are non-doctors. So
okay.
what we have now, Karen, is we have several teams operating. Meron kami parang triage din when they take the initial data from the patient. Meron na dong mga doktor. Meron na doon mga doktor na nag-a-advise sa triage kung kanino yung pasyente i-ililink.
Okay.
So parang we have a number of stages and we have specialists who see patients upon the recommendation of the general practitioners.
Okay. And pwede magreseta ang doktor? Pwede. Okay. Anything on COVID management? Yes. Ang tanong ko, will the doctor say you have to, I have to refer you to the one hospital command?
Yes.
They have to move you to a, let's say, a quarantine facility?
Yes.
Yun ba ang role?
Yun yung role, Karen. Meron kaming mga ano eh, meron kaming mga prompts. We have questions which would determine whether or not the patient would need emergency care. Kasi yung pinaka-concept ng teleconsulta namin for outpatients. Ito yung mga outpatient na won't need to go to the hospital but would need to talk to a doctor for medical advice. Pero when the doctor deems it necessary that this particular patient needs to be seen in a hospital or needs hospital confinement, we have another team na sumasalo.
I see.
Yung team na sumasalo. And Karen, yun yung aming problema. Yun yung aming problema because we have to operate parang under the protocols that we have. Kaya kami, yung mga kailangan dalhin sa ospital, kami yung nagko-contact sa one hospital command.
Okay, so just very quickly, you have 500 doctors right now. Is this 24 hours itong e-consulta, Vice President?
Yung plano, not yet. Kasi right now, Karen, nag-onboard kami. Ang gusto sabihin, we have sessions with the doctors to discuss with them the processes, the protocols that we need to follow. Parang kahapon, you were able to onboard, if I am not mistaken, more than 50. So yun pa lang, parang hindi sila magte-take in ng patients na hindi pa sila onboarded. Para we operate on a single, parang protocol lang.
So
ngayon, every day, Karen, kahapon, nakailang onboarding kami. And today, ganun na naman. Pero yung first batch of doctors who onboarded already, nag-duty na kahapon.
Oo. So para lang malinaw, no, let's say I'm going to register. Gusto ko magpakonsulta ng libre. I go on Facebook. I'll write my name, pati ba cellphone ko, may hihinging data. Tapos tatawag ang doktor sa akin. Ganun po ba yun?
Actually, agent namin yung tumatawag.
Okay.
Agent namin yung tumatawag tapos kino-connect niya yung pasyente sa doktor. Kasi kami naman, Karen, we don't want to burden the doctors too much. Ayaw naman namin sila pa yung gagastos ng load kasi volunteers lang sila eh. So yung ginagawa namin, meron kami sistema na nililink namin sila. So ang ginagawa when you enter our website, pupunta ka sa Messenger.
Okay.
Sa Messenger, tapos there are a set of questions na tinatanong sa'yo. Tapos yun yung pag-decide kung paano siya i-handle. Halimbawa, okay, pag emergency, yun yung mga red flags sa amin. Binabato na agad siya sa isang team.
Oo. Alright. And quickly, how quick should the response be? Let's say nag-register ako today. Ano dapat ang protocol ninyo? Gano'ng kabilis dapat ang linking?
Sa depende, Karen. Meron kaming mga codes. Meron kaming mga codes na, halimbawa yung red, dapat immediate. Tapos yung susunod doon, yung yellow, dapat within the day.
Okay.
Tapos, basta ano siya, parang may mga stages. But we send them messages to inform them what they are waiting for. Nagka-problema lang kami, Karen, during our first day. Kasi we weren't expecting na yung influx grabe na magbe-message. Na-flag kami ng Facebook, so we were not able to use the system.
How many messaged you? Already for consultation?
100+ during the first few hours.
So people
Ang problema pa rin, meron kasing mga, alimbawa, when you enter Messenger, parang you will type too long. The prompt that you need teleconsultation services. Sa dami ng tulong na pumasok, yun yata yung may automatic na flag yung Facebook. AI yata yung nagpa-flag. Sumara yung sistema namin.
Is it open now?
It was down for a few hours last Wednesday.
Alright.
So we were able to push through again Wednesday evening. So kahapon medyo marami yung aming backlog.
Yeah.
Okay. May backlog. And ngayong araw, we'll still be devoted to catching up.
Okay.
Doon sa backlog of the first day.
All right. But I think it's good to know. Mahalagang malaman ng tao na may option kasi na may makausap silang doktor. Let's discuss the swab cab. It was a success. Many have said, and you first went to Malabon. That was the first area you targeted. Let's get the details of that. How many were swabbed? And what is the operation? Like, for example, is there a protocol before you swab someone? What is taken? Paano ginagawa, ma'am?
Yun, Karen, that's why we have received a lot of requests already for the swab cab. Pero yeah, we need partnership with the LGU kasi we have a lot of limitations. Yung pinaka first step, Karen, yung LGU will identify who will be swabbed. Kasi hindi naman namin alam yung area. Diba? Okay. Hindi namin alam yung area. Uh-oh. So, yung mga pinapadala nila, those with symptoms, those who were contact traced, or surveillance testing in areas where, in communities where transmission is high.
And you do this for free. It's coming from the office of the vice president. So let's be specific. Like the swab cab last Monday for Malabon. So that was swab antigen, no? Tama?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Swab antigen. How many did you swab? How many kits? I'm sure some were spoiled. Some weren't used. Paano?
Mga almost 1,300 people, Karen.
Okay.
1,300 people were swabbed.
Okay, and how much does the office spend? Like, for example, that swab cab in Malabon, that you had volunteers, you had to feed them, you had to buy antigen tests, over 1,000 people. What is the budget for something like that? If you have a businessman watching now and would like to donate, let's say Pasay, swab cab in Pasay, and there's big business in Pasay, and will say, let me just donate this one swab cab day sa office of the vice president for Pasay. How much is spent?
Actually, Karen, yung Malabon run kasi, we did not spend for the antigen tests.
Okay.
Because there were donations.
Okay.
There were donations, so we used the donations, yung kaya na, from donate, these are donations to kaya natin. It was kaya natin who bought the antigen tests.
Okay.
Pero we have appropriated already. Parang after Malabon, we will be, we have bought antigen tests already for the runs in other LGUs.
And how much did you appropriate considering, you know, you have limited funds? How much were you able to appropriate for these antigen tests?
Well, actually, Karen, I'm not very sure of the exact amount, pero I believe we are appropriating for 22,000 more antigen tests because yung initial namin na donated 3,000. Right now, parang yung first batch that the Office of the Vice President will be spending for is another 22,000 antigen tests. Kami, Karen, we're buying FDA-approved antigen tests. Yung first batch, ang alam ko, abot
okay.
Namin binili. I don't know etong susunod. Pero, Karen, we had a lot of lessons in Malabon.
Okay, what were the lessons?
Ano ba, Karen, yung first day, we wanted to swab 1,500 people.
Okay.
And first day, a lot of those who were identified by the barangays, a lot of those identified by the LGUs didn't want to be swabbed.
Okay.
Didn't want to be swabbed because most of them were afraid that, you know, if they test positive, they will be brought to the isolation centers. And if they are brought to the isolation centers, they won't be able to work. So if they won't be able to work, walang kakainin yung pamilya. Ang iba naman, may inaalagaan na anak, ayaw kong dalhin ako sa isolation center. Walang mag-aalaga sa anak ko. So, yun yung nangyari sa first day. Kaya first day, Karen, we were only able to swab, I think, a little over 500.
Yeah.
Nung bumalik kami nung Tuesday, kasi yung una namin, yung Holy Week, tapos bumalik kami ng Tuesday. Nung bumalik kami ng Tuesday, meron na kaming incentives. Meron na kaming incentives for every person na magpapaswab. nagbigay kami ng bigas. Nagbigay kami ng bigas.
That's quite innovative. Yeah, oo, that's okay. So, pag lahat ng magpapaswab, binigyan yung bigas or pag nag-positive, bibigyan ng bigas?
Okay. Iba pa yung package sa nag-positive ka rin. Sa nag-positive, mas marami. It's an entire package na para to assure the person who tested positive na may kakainin yung pamilya niya habang nasa isolation center siya. So yun yung unang lesson. Yung pangalawang lesson, yung quality ng isolation center.
Okay.
Kasi marami din yung tao na ayaw, maraming tao na ayaw magpaswab kasi hindi komportable doon sa isolation center. So the first day that we were swabbing Karen, nagse-set up din kami ng isolation center. And buti na lang LGU Malabon has been very, very cooperative. Merong isang paaralan doon na buti na lang pinahiram yung LGU Malabon. We converted that. We put up tents para may privacy yung bawat isa. Inayos namin yung mga banyo. Nilagyan namin ng mga facilities na
so you spent for that too? The office spent for that?
Yes.
Okay, but isolation center, hindi na mura yun, ma'am.
Ano siya, Karen? Actually, we used most of the resources that we was included in the isolation center, we already had, like the tents. Okay. Alam mo yung mga tents na nilagay namin doon, may tents na talaga kami, Karen, kasi we lend these tents pag merong mga sakuna. Pag merong nasunukan, merong bagyo, etc. So gumamit kami noon. Yung mga mattresses namin, donated. Mga mattresses donated. Yung binili yata namin, if I am not mistaken, mga beddings. Bumili din kami, Karen, ng mga kits. Ito yung parang may mga COVID kits na nandun yung mga vitamins na iinumin.
Yeah.
Nandun yung paracetamol, yung para sa ubo, merong pulse oximeter, merong thermometer.
Yeah. Okay.
The basics that every COVID positive patient need to have.
Okay, so quickly on this, if I remember correctly, of the 1,500 people you tested under the swab cab in Malabon, is it right 5 tested positive?
No, 80.
80, oh, I'm sorry.
It's actually 1,000 to almost 1,300, not 1,500.
All right, and the 80 right now that who tested positive are now in the isolation centers you put up. You set aside food for the families, is it correct, for 2 weeks?
Yes. Actually, Karen, when we learned our lesson from the first day, yung second day, ang ginawa na namin, Karen, may naghihintay ng ambulansya katabi ng swab cup. So that every time a person tests positive, hinihiwalay na kaagad siya. Ba-a. So yung ambulansya, dadalhin na siya doon sa isolation center. And then nagko-contact trace na immediately. This is the beauty about antigen tests because you get the results 15-20 minutes after.
Yeah.
So nakahanda na yung B-Hertz ng barangay. Pag may nag-positive, magko-contact trace na siya sa pamilya, sa mga kapitbahay. So dadalhin na din nila sa swab cab yung pamilya sa mga kapitbahay. Okay.
Is this how you define mass testing? Because one of your recommendations last Easter is really, other than prevention, is to ramp up mass testing. You and Congresswoman Stella Kimbo, in which the testings are, Vince Deason said, no, I don't agree with mass testing. It should be risk and targeted only. But there seems to be a confusion for some on the definition of mass testing when it's quite clear with the DOH, the British Medical Journal, how mass testing is defined. Yeah. So is this mass testing for you in actuality?
Actually, Karen, I'm very careful not to use the term mass testing.
Okay.
Mass testing in communities where transmission is high. Pero hindi mass testing na buong Pilipinas. Test. Sa akin, mas targeted siya. You do a lot of testing in communities where transmission is very high. And if you look at all the best practices of countries who were quite successful with their COVID-19 response, this was one of the basics that they did. Halimbawa, Karen, yung Vietnam. Yung Vietnam, napaka-proactive nila as far as testing is concerned. once they detect that there is community transmission, they do mass testing already in that particular community. Yeah. Ang kabutihan na to, they are able to detect, they are very able to detect very, very early. So pag na-detect nila, they are able to do aggressive contact tracing and they are able to isolate. Pag ganito kasi karan, hindi na nagsispread. Kasi para sa akin, halimbawa, we were able to test 80 people. Test positive. Who tested
correct.
Positive.
Correct.
So sa akin lang, kung hindi sila na-test positive, baka gumagala-gala pa yung mga.
Correct. Oo. Oo.
Hindi nila alam na pero na pala sila.
Baka.
So yung sa akin, we have to be quite proactive as far as testing is concerned.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi yung sa amin, Karen, it was easier to convince people to get themselves tested. Kasi yung testing nandun na sa labas ng bahay nila.
Mm-hmm.
Pero if you will ask them, pipila ka sa ganitong ospital for testing, talagang ayaw.
Yeah. Okay, that's very interesting. And you did say you're careful to use the word mass testing. It's technically only for communities wherein transmission is very high, someone tested positive, so you mass test within that community.
Yes.
So VP, I just wanted to ask you, so is it fair to say Vince Dizon wasn't entirely wrong? Is that correct?
I think kasi yung definition niya, I'm sorry, Karen, I didn't hear the interview of Vince, so I might be unfair.
Yeah.
Pero baka kasi yung definition ng mass testing niya, itetest yung lahat ng mga Pilipino. And that's not what we mean.
Uh-oh.
Ang sinasabi lang natin, test more in areas where transmission is really high. Kasi
yes.
Sa DOH puts up a SOC card every day. Pag tinignan mo, Karen, yung SOC card, halimbawa yesterday, positivity rate was 20% and testing was 39,000. So,
sobrang konti.
Because you have to target na yung positivity rate mo should be below 5%.
Yeah.
And pag ang positivity rate mo sobrang ang taas, dapat yung denominator mo, taasan mo.
And that denominator
is the number of tests that you conduct.
Oo. And I think what's interesting in this swab cab concept is you actually go and have them tested, because to assume that people will line up in hospitals, you're right, is frankly too much for the ordinary Filipino. Parang magtatrabaho na lang ako kesa pumila pa ako, tapos baka singilin pa ako. Alam mo yun? So, and the incentives. Now, how many cities in NCR do you... Anong target mo? You've done Malabon. Can you give us the timeline of the cities, VP?
Actually, Karen, we can go to any city as long as the LGU is willing to partner with us. Kasi kulang yung tao namin. Yun yung problema namin, Karen. Alimbawa, we can't do... Meron kaming volunteer swabbers. Meron kaming volunteer team. But what we can't do is do the groundwork, preliminary groundwork. Dapat LGU yun. Susunod doon, after a person tests positive, hindi din namin kaya na kami yung magko-contact trace.
Tama.
So, dapat ano yun, cargo ng LGU. Sila yung magko-contact trace.
And they know the people.
Yes. As far as facilities is concerned, we can donate or we can help with setting up. Pero yung lugar mismo, wala kaming lugar. So kaya yung magpo-provide ng lugar, we're willing to do tents, we're willing to give folding beds, mattresses, pero yung lugar mismo, kayo yung magpo-provide. So we've been receiving requests, Karen.
I'm curious, where is your next city? That would be interesting to para abangan na yon. Where is the next?
Most probably, Karen, in Marikina, because we receive, pero this is preliminary.
Yeah.
We are meeting with the team of Congresswoman Stella Kingbo today.
Okay.
She did the request, I think, 2 days ago. And she was very receptive when we said, we're okay to go there as long as you provide for this, and this.
Yeah.
And she's very receptive. But sinabi niya na this is what I've been wanting to do for so long. Pero yung iba kasi ang LGUs na nagre-request, Karen, when we say na you will do the groundwork, you will do the contact tracing, we won't go there if there is no isolation facility available, umaayaw na. Or pag sinasabi na, teka, yes, na hindi pa namin yun kaya ngayon, magsasabi kami pagkaya na namin. Kasi ako, I don't blame the LGUs, Karen.
Yeah, pagod na.
Saka their hands are really full now. Lalo yung mga B-hurts nila. Sa Malabon nga, Karen, sobrang bilib ako sa mga B-hurts na yung the dedication talagang mapapahanga ka. Yung binabahay-bahay.
Oo.
Binabahay-bahay yung mga tao.
Okay. Will the swab cab go, just very quickly, outside Metro Manila, like general Manila area? We are in an NCR plus bubble.
Yes.
Would
yes.
you go as far as that?
Uh-oh. Yes. Basta it's within NCR bubble. We've been receiving requests from Cavite, from Bulacan, from Pampanga. Pero yun nga, Karen, pag sinasabi na namin na we don't have, pag sinasabi na namin yung limitations namin, like we give free tests, kami yung magdadala ng cab, kami yung pwede kami yung mag-provide ng mga swabbers, pero itong gagawin, doon talaga sila napapaisip. Kasi parang parati nilang sinasabi, Kailangan namin yan, but our B-hurts are very, very busy now. So, magsasabi kami pag ready na kami.
What's interesting is this is something the DOH can do. You know, instead of this centralized system where you expect the people, go and have yourself tested, it's the government going down to the people and saying, look, the test is here, we've chosen you. If you're positive, this is the food. It's completely a different way to approach testing. I'm curious if, I'm sure you've written this in a paper you've submitted before. Is anybody in the DOH, even the undersecretaries or the team assigned, are they receptive to doing this method, VP?
Ako naman, Karen, in fairness to DOH, we have briefings with them, we meet with them. Tingin ko lang, Karen, yung hirap talaga, parang a lot of people are so overwhelmed now.
Yeah.
Di ba sinasabi ko to since last year na parang kulang yung nagtitimon.
Yeah.
Na, you know, when you're in a crisis, talagang di ba yung problema, parang sobrang dami. Na pag ang problema sobrang dami, ang dami mo na hindi naaasikaso kasi ang dami mong ginagawa.
Oo.
So sa akin, it would be very beneficial sana if there is another team who is monitoring na ito pa yung hindi nagagawa. Ito yung dapat gawin. Ito yung mga problema. Parang yun yung kulang. And I think it's because everyone is so overwhelmed now. Parang kulang yung nag-organize ng latan.
Oh, okay. Now, you have to forgive me for this question because I know you agreed to this interview really to speak about programs. But coming from, you said last year, kulang ang nagtitimon. I want to ask you, you have netizens criticizing the president, asking, where is he? Would you say kulang ang nagtitimon, hindi siya nagtitimon enough ngayon?
Ako, it doesn't, alam mo yung nagtitimon, Karen, doesn't have to be the president. Although para sa akin, malaking bagay kung presidente nagtitimon kasi hindi makakahindi. Alam mo yun pag sinabihan mo na parang it's different if let's say si Secretary Galvez yung nag-order ng mga interviews. Pag si presidente yun, talagang mas mabilis. Mas mabilis kung siya mismo yung nandoon. Pero sa akin, kung hindi si presidente yun, there has to be somebody na yung ginagawa niya lang. Parang conductor sa orchestra, he doesn't play the instrument, but he's the one who's putting order in a lot of things. Mm-hmm. Yun yung nakikita ko na kulang ngayon. Kasi in fairness to everyone, parang everyone is working naman, Karen. Everyone is working, everyone are already, parang everyone is exhausted already from last year pa tayo. Pero yun nga kahit dito sa opisina namin, Karen, in a smaller office like ours, ako, tutok na tutok ako sa operations. Ako yung nagsasabing, kahit sa Bayanihan E-konsulta ka rin,
yeah,
I have access to all the patients who are writing us. Ako mismo yung nagsasabing, ito, mabagal tayo dito, dagdag na tayo ng doktor kasi ang daming pasyente. yung dati nating budget ng doktor kulang na. Kung sino matatawagan natin, tawagan na natin. Ako mismo. I've been calling up my doctor friends yesterday. Yeah. Pwede bang mahubot ka namin? Kasi ang dami namin backlog, ganito. Parang walang ganon.
Mm-hmm. Walang ganon. Okay.
Importante yun, Karen, eh. Kasi kailangan na parang may nagtutulak. Mm-hmm. Kasi marami talagang ginagawa ngayon. And it can be very overwhelming talaga.
Okay. Before I ask you about the WHO, we will talk about the WHO call last night warning the Philippines already that we might be crossing what they say the red line in its healthcare capacity. I'll ask you about short-term solutions, mid-term solutions. But before we go into a break, I want to add, people are looking for the president, questioning about his health. Would you want to say something about that?
Ako, Karen, nakikita ko naman siya sa social media, pero para sa akin, importante naman. In crisis situations, kahit hindi presidente, kahit nga mayor, di ba? Pag may nangyari sa lugar mo na yung people wait for your mayor to be visible, to say that everything is all right, we're on top of the situation, this is what we're doing. I think yun yung pinapanggalingan. Yun yung pinapanggalingan na assurance na everything is under control. Mm-hmm. Kasi pag wala yung assurance na yun, Karen, yung tao, nasa stress siya eh. Parating ang tanong, saan na ba tayo papunta? Kaya pa ba natin? I think that's where it is all coming from. Pero para sa akin, gaya sa amin, rather than spend a lot of time looking for this and that, gagawin na lang namin yung kaya namin gawin kasi kailangan ng tao.
Okay.
So yung sa akin may basis kung bakit naghahanap kasi gano'n naman. Hindi lang presidente, kahit governor, mayor, basta may nangyayari sa lugar mo. It's the natural, parang natural instinct
reaction
to look for their leader.